Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yabrah. YisraYah, you may be seated. Hallelujah. We do. Toda Yah for all things, for the blessed assurance that we have by the revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach. It's vitally important that we understand what revelation is. It is the power of Yah's truth made known. And that is Yada. We have learned to know, we recognize it is of Yah. We have experienced it. And now we have the power to discriminate, to discern what is right and what is wrong. Now that is what the revelation is. It is not some kind of epiphany that many declare that they receive revelation. It doesn't come that way. It comes by the understanding, the binah, the power to discern, the power to know what is of Yah and what is not of Yah. And many times, because we don't understand the characteristics of Yah, we don't know who He is. And so we have painted this delusional picture in our mind. This is what constitutes the great I am. And that is not the picture of Him at all. He is far from what we perceive Him to be, YisraYah, because we have allowed our minds to become so convoluted and so polluted. We don't even know what's right and what's wrong today. We will not acknowledge what is wrong, offensive unto Yah, what is against Him, and what He delights in and what is pleasing. We are a nation of people that literally hide our iniquity in our bosom. And Yah says, I'm going to reward YisraYah according to your own ovon, your mind that has been shaped and nurtured by concepts that abandoned the direction, the ordinance of the Torah. And if we think of our everyday activity, it is one that does not allow the Torah to constitute the image of Yah, the mind of Yahshua, the purpose of Yah, the will of Yah. We don't say, Yah, if it's your will, I will do a certain thing. It is what my will is, not the will of Yah. We simply do not care. We are not concerned about His will, so we do our will instead of His will. And we don't understand that this is the power of the spiritual military complex that wars against Yah. There's a battle, and the battle is on, and the weapons are drawn. The chali, the weapons, the instruments of destruction, the garments of destruction. And Yah is dressed in the garment of chali, His weaponry, His ornaments of destruction and death. I was listening the other day as I scan radio stations when I drive. I may listen here 30 seconds, here 30 seconds. I never listen to one thing constantly. That's not how I listen to things. I'm always scanning. And I heard this man that calls himself a preacher, he said the other day, it is one thing that the people do not want any kind of negative messages. What he calls negative is when we are confronted with the ills of our wickedness and our sins, when Yah began to reveal unto us those things that He disapproved of. We must understand that, YisraYah. He said everyone wants to hear a positive message. They don't want to hear anything negative. Everything Yah says is positive. This whole book consists of two things, actually. It shows us the path that we must walk in to please Him. And everything else is about His mishpatim, His judgment. That's what this book is about. It is a book of judgment. It is a book of correction. It shows us our ways that are vile. It shows us an attitude that has disdain for Him. He shows us the correction. Now, if you don't get it right, then woe unto you, my people, the nations of the earth. So the book is about judgment. And we see the pattern and the examples in the book when a people forsook Yah and were about to establish their own righteousness, then death and hell, destruction, and every kind of vile thing was upon that people. We see that today, Yisraya, with the laws, how man changed his laws. Well, the Torah is the same today, yesterday, and throughout the kingdom. The Torah will not change. We have a law that is so twisted that people today don't even know what is a man and what is a woman. They're training your children to hate anything that is correct, to hate everything that is pure. And you give your sons and daughters into the hands of those of the bastard slip. And give one generation, these children will not even know what pure love is when they find two damn faggot dogs kissing each other, two damn sluttish bulldagger dyke women embracing and kissing, and yet the parents do not say a damn thing. You give your children to this damn wicked world, and you tell me you love them. You are a damnable, twisted Jezebel of a mammy. You are a slothful, wicked dog of a man. You have no damn credence in my presence. You may get that with the faggots and the dogs, but with me you have no credence at all. You have no strength. You have no validation with me at all. And this is what is happening. And so this is a part of HaShatan's, his military complex to fight against Yah. The weapons of his enforcement, his armament, as he trained the minds of your children, he has trained your mind that you will not even oppose that which is wicked. You don't even identify what is wrong. You don't identify what's in you that is wrong and vile before Almighty Yah. You don't even oppose it. You don't even acknowledge your wicked ways. If my people would acknowledge, hear my voice, if they will acknowledge their wickedness, their sins, and turn from their wicked ways, we will not even acknowledge our wickedness, our shrewdness of corruption. We won't even acknowledge that, Yisrael. And we wonder why we're in the state of misery and darkness, while our conscience is never on Yah, while we are deceitful and liars and corrupt. We're evil toward Yah. And that is the nature of the people that declare that they are the sons and daughters of Yisrael. That's their nature. They do not give a damn about one another. Let no one deceive you to make you think that they care for each other. The only thing is that the children of the world are wiser than the children of Yah, because they're wiser to do evil. And they know how to do evil in a wise way to cover their evil. We are just so damn ignorant. We don't realize we're doing evil. And we are offensive unto Yah. And he is gathering his weapons to battle against Yisrael and the nations of the earth. He has an armament that you don't know of. You have heard of it, but you don't regard it at all. I was sitting the other day with my Ach Simeon, and I said to him, do you know what the weapons of Yah are? Oh, I know we all think we know according to Roniah, but you just don't know Yisrael. We don't even mandate it of ourselves to Lahai, to study. We don't even put a mandate on ourselves to do that. But we will put a mandate on ourselves to satisfy every wicked proclivity, desire, purpose, urgency of our own damn twisted, wicked minds and our desires. We have no problem doing that. But when it comes to Almighty Yah, there is nothing in us that drives us, compels us, to force us, to coerce us, that we must feed the mind of Yah daily for it to grow, for it to expand, for the knowledge to increase. For you will grow not just hearing his imams, but you grow in the wisdom, the yada, the understanding, the chuchma, the ability to discern and to speak emphatically It is not of Yah, it is wrong, it is wicked. We don't even press beyond our own corrupt nature to do that. We don't even drive ourselves to meditate day and night upon the Torah of Yah, and that is simply to study, to embrace, to give yourself over unto it, to have the quietness of time, to embrace the scripture of Yah, and to allow it to burn and to create in our mind the very image of Yah, His power, His might, His truth, that we will be pure. It takes a fire to get anything pure. You cannot get hot water without fire. You don't want to wash your clothes in cold water. You want hot water. It's something that it does to extract that sod that is in the clothing. And it's going to take the same fire to get the wickedness out of the people of Yah. We are a people that do not love Yah. We say we do, but we don't love Him. And that's the truth. And I am not going to stop preaching this way. You understand? I am not. If it's negative, it will be negative. Yahshua did not go around telling us how to get rich, how to have homes. He told you who your family was. He told you those that will come against you. He told us that our foes, a man's foes, shall be of his own house. He did not tell us that those that I meet on the street will be my foe. He did not tell me that, YisraYah. Our opposition, he told us things that we would be tried by, we would be opposed by, we would be pressed against, YisraYah. And he tells us what to do. He tells us that we as the nation of YisraYah, who are those that love Yah, those that hear the word, the Torah, and obey it. We must love the Torah of Yah. You don't let nothing supersede the Torah. I don't care who it is, not wife, children. You don't allow that to supersede the Torah, not husband, no one. You do what's right. You press on in the knowledge of Yah's truth. You press on despite who's with you. Yahushua said, as far as me and my house, we're going to serve Yah. We're going to walk in the delight of Torah. We're going to obey Yah. We're going to oblige Almighty Yah and all that He commands us, the weapons of Yah. I want to teach this today, preach a little bit. May not be as long as I was last Shabbat, but that's all right. Whether you become perplexed or you become discomforted with me, that's all right. We need to grow up, YisraYah. Our homes need to be strengthened. We need to get some resolve in our minds. We have no strength. We don't have strength to do a damn thing. Not anything at all. There is no deep resolve in us. We cannot even press against the God that rules us, and that's the God of this internal corruption that is in us. It has been created by our own corruption. I did not create your God. You did not create my gods. You have created a God that is so internal, corrupt in you, even when you try, you cannot. Even in your best day of pressing, you cannot go beyond the wheel of that vile nature that oppose Yah to bring about the beauty, the excellence of Yahshua in our lives. You can't even press beyond that. I don't care how you try. I don't care how you commit yourself. That's why there must be a birth of the power of the Ruach of Yah. We must have the transformation of our mind. And our minds must be transformed. We still got the same old damn dirty minds we had yesterday, last year, and the year before that. We still have the same damn dirty minds. We still do the same damn wickedness that we did last year and year before last. Even a child understands that they don't do things as a child as they grow. Even a child understands as they grow that these things are not valuable or important to do at this time. And they go beyond that stage of childhood. We as the children of Yah, we have not gone beyond the stage of childhood. We are not going beyond that. We are still childish and children. That's what we are. He must often reprove us. And that's what we often stiffen our neck. We hard our resolve. Nobody is going to tell me, I don't want to be that ignorant. I don't want to be that wicked. We hear the Torah of Yah. We don't harden our hearts. I live Him as in the days of provocation. We don't provoke Yah. We receive His truth. We allow it to purge us and to correct us. We allow the fire of His correction to show us even our own damnation as we oppose Yah. We allow that to show us that, Yisra'yah, that we are not offended at what He speaks unto us. As that man said the other day, we want to hear things that we perceive are positive. I don't want to hear lies to deceive me and to corrupt my mind and turn me away from truth. I don't want that. In essence, he was saying, no one wants y'all to be forthright with us. We don't want y'all to be forthright, to tell us our state of condition, our mindset, to tell us how disloyal we are. Because we think we're loyal and we're not loyal. We break the mitzvah of Yah, we are full of deceits. I'm going to teach something here today, whether you concur or agree, but I will teach from the book. And if you oppose that, you want to debate me, I have no problem with that at all. I want to amplify one thing, the weaponry of the armament of Yah, the weapon. We see what the enemy is doing. They're killing your children. And you just don't give a damn. You don't give a damn. We should train them up, and I'm going to teach that next Shabbat. Train them up. What do you train them in? In the way that they should walk, that they should, the way that they should go the path. And the Torah is precise when they are all, they shall not depart. Either Yah is a liar, as Hashatan, or he told us the truth. Either he has lied to us, he said they will not depart. And we're departing. I know I wasn't trained in the way of Yah, but we're like children now. He's training us. And the reason we do not proceed farther, because we don't hear. I've been in the military, and those men that trained us in that time and that era, they had gone to Vietnam. They had fought. They had saw many dead, 2 and 3 tours. They knew what it was going to take. For us, when we go there, to be alert, to be sharp. And they did not allow you 2 mistakes. They only allowed you 1, and that was it. And when they went struck you, they meant for you to hear them. And they were not men that were intimidated or timid or soft. They were strong men. You could see it in their physical prowess. They were strong men. They were physically built. Their minds were sharp. Where they were walking, the uniform was tailored and everything fitted, and they looked like massive men, and they could run as far as the smallest man. They could do pull-ups and push-ups, and they could do all of the activities beyond our ability to do it. And they knew what they had to do was to change that little sensual, effeminate mindset, that we can develop a mind of strength, and that is what the enemy is doing. He's developing a mind in your children, this generation, to abandon, to fight against Yah. And you parents trust the workers of darkness more than you trust the Ruach of Yah. You give your sons and your daughters into their hands. They won't even know what a marriage is in the future. They won't even know what is right and wrong. He will not know what situation to apply himself to. The boy will bring a man home and say, I'm going to marry the man. The woman bringing a woman home saying, I'm going to marry a woman. That's not of Yah. These are the weapons of the spiritual military complex that are against Yah. And they're battling in our mind. We must begin at the first gate of our own minds to acknowledge your own wrong. To acknowledge it when you're wicked, you're wrong, and to say it and to testify it, and speak of your ill, to confess it, that you may gain strength. You will never gain it if you do not testify of it. There are those that like to hide their wickedness. Well, you shouldn't say that. That's what a man or a woman are able to confess their wrong. You will find one that has strength when you find one that wants to hide it. That is the weak, shallow individual. They will do every kind of damn wickedness. I don't have a damn thing. I don't hide in my house. I don't wait till I clear things up for you to come in. You don't have a damn thing. We hide. The cloak of our own damn wickedness. Well, don't tell nobody you did that. No, you tell hell that they will not be entrapped by the same demise of Hashatan. I want to show something today. This is a prideful generation. It's full of pride. It's an arrogant, haunted generation. And it doesn't give a damn about the Most High. It damns the Most High. the mother, the fathers, the grannies, the great-grannies, they all, in their actions. You can say one thing, but your action speaks louder than any damn verbal expression you have. I want to identify Yah, first of all, how he makes himself known unto us. If there is any man that could give us any clarity on that, it was Dawid. He makes a statement here. I'm going to teach on today, preach. I'm going to exalt on the weapons of Yah, the slaughtering cheli, the weapons of Yah. What are they? What are the weapons of Yah? What are the instruments of his battle? What is the clothing of his battle? That he shall rage against the nations of the earth, because we have abandoned even the truth of Almighty Yah. And as a nation, Yisrael, we have abandoned his truth. We don't even delight in it at all. That's why there's much sickness among us in the mind. We are sick people. We are weak people. We are a people of no strength and no character. We are not a people that's a blessing. And Yah said, his word said, you will be a Berechiah, a blessing unto all nations. We're not a blessing unto the nations of the earth. Not at all. We're not a blessing unto one another. And that's just a fact. We're great pretenders, Yisrael. We want someone to soothe us in our own damn wickedness and tell us it's going to be all right. No, it's not all right. Things are not well with us. We are damn sick people. Our minds are so corrupt. We abandon truth for evil. We are practitioners of every kind of damn evil act there is. We don't give a damn. We don't care. We don't even know what the Ahab of Yah is. And that's the truth. That's his people. And how can we as a nation that is supposed to represent Yah? I was speaking to the Ach the other day. I said, everything that a man does, his Ishaw, she is a meets. She represents that beauty and that authority. That is what his woman represents, not just some damn meat in the bed. He didn't cut a man of tenacity and strength. He was the nurturous woman that way. A damn weak man doesn't give a damn. You nurture her that even when the world sees you, they will see the strength. When they see a man of strength, then they will look at his Ishaw and they can see the nurturing of that power, her strength that prevails from her bosom. They can see when they interact. It's not Yah coming for a woman. With the broad of Yahshua, is he strong? Is he mighty? Do we represent him? Do we represent the characteristics of that? That's why he gave him something so precious that even gold and silver and all the riches of the world cannot amount to what a precious daughter that is on your own is. What a precious bath. She has been turned into a ruthless, wicked, vile thing, and the man has become an effeminate piece of nothing. And that is the truth. You know the power of a man by the beauty of his Ishaw. You understand the strength of a single man by the strength of the one that fathered him. And that is the truth. I don't give a damn whether you love me, because your love is superficial even for you. You can't even love you. How are you going to love me? I don't give a damn. I want to open up here. And above all, I want to understand the weaponry of Yah. What are the weapons of Yah? As I said to Ach Simeon, I say, what are the weapons of Yah? Oh, he and I, we have heated debates at times. We will sit down in the Torah. If you're wrong, I'm wrong. I have no problem acknowledging my wrong. I said, what are the weapons of Yah? And we just looked at each other. There was no discourse in that. I didn't ask him, could he tell me? I knew what the weapons are and what they were. I didn't ask that. I said, maybe I'll preach that one day. And today is the day I will preach it, the weapons, the slaughtering weapons, the weapons of death. The mapa, the weapons of death,
the smiting weapons that smite and destroy and to break in pieces of Yah, his keli. That's why the Chadve tells us that a woman should not put on that which pertain unto a man. It is keli. It's talking about the dress as well, how one's dress, their garments, what they wear and what they put on. And Yah has already arrayed himself in his weaponry. And we shall see the very smiting, the mapa, the destruction, the shattering into pieces, the nations, people of the nations as well. Dawid says this to us. There is no way you go to Yada to recognize, experience Yah into Helium chapter 9, verse 16. There is no way you're going to be able to recognize Yah. When you recognize him, then you must admit that this is the work of Yah. And that is what Yada is. It is just not that I know. You must acknowledge that. You must have the ability to admit that this is of Yah. And this is the hand of Almighty Yah. You must admit it. You must have the knowledge. And the only way you're going to have the knowledge, you must Yada. And that you learn through the experience with Yah, that you recognize that this is Yah. You know that this is the hand of Yah. And then you will know when he speaks in volume by the hearing of the Torah of Yah. Dawid cries out in the midst of all of his travail and great agony. In the midst of all of his trials, he says this unto us in Tehillim chapter 9, verse 16. He says, Yahweh is Yada, he is known, he is revealed unto us. There are many that will quote part of what Yahshua said, for Yahshua came not to condemn the world. Why? Because the world was already condemned. It was already damned. It was already condemned. This world is condemned. You can even find a glimmer of light among the world that represents the beauty of Almighty Yah. It is twisted. It is contorted. And everybody is going about seeking their own and doing their own. Yah is known. He is Yada. You recognize him because when the Ruach comes, the first thing the Ruach does, it began to judge the world of sin. Our minds are worldly. Our minds are captivated by the world. Our minds are given over unto the world. Our minds are worldly minds. Our minds are minds that do not love the hearing of the Torah. And so that's what the Ruach HaKodesh does. It comes to reprove. It comes to chastise us, to rebuke us, to show us our vile ways that are corrupt and wicked. And so Yah is known. He is Yada. He is known by the Mishpat, his judgment. He is known by his ordinance of what? Justice. Is he just? Will he judge us? Is he just? We must understand that is one thing the enemy has taken out of our mind, because there are three unclean spirits that Yahkahan talked about in Revelation that came out of the mouth. He saw three unclean spirits like frogs that came out of the mouth of HaShatan, the false prophet, and out of this religious order. He saw that. He saw it. We must understand what those three spirits are. We don't even know because we don't give a damn. All we care about is our God, our belly. We don't study the book, and we are sick people. Our minds are sick. So we hear something that is of substance, we don't know how to digest it. We get upset. We get mad. We begin to defend us, and we don't defend Yah because we don't know. And the reason we don't know, because we don't hear. We're not susceptible to hear what Yah says. Yah is known. He is Yada. You will recognize that it is him when he comes in the ordinance of his just ways and the justness of Yah, that he judge every matter. He judge everything. There's not a matter that Yah does not judge. There's not a matter that you do not judge. There's not a matter that you do not have an opinion on. There's not a matter that Yah doesn't judge. He judge every thought. How do I know that? Are we going to be judged by some of the words or every word that comes out of our mouth? He judged every word. He judged every thought. And because of our ignorance, we don't realize that he is making himself known unto us when he judges us. He said, all right, you're wrong. Those words are wrong. The way you said it was wrong. Your actions are wrong. Your attitude is wrong. Your conniving ways, your sneaky ways, your vile ways, they're wrong. He judged everything. He judged every action, every word, everything we say, everything we do, every look, every thought. He judged that. And the Ruach always corrects that and leads us into the gate of truth, that we will not give ourselves over unto that spirit again. That we said he make himself known unto Yisra'iah, Mahis Mishat, his judgment, which he execute. He execute, the word execute, asa, to do, to fashion, to accomplish. His judgment is what accomplish what he needs in us. His judgment is what fashion our minds, Yisra'iah. His judgment is what fashion our thoughts. His judgment is what asa. It is what fashion us. It is what makes us complete. It is what makes us like him. He commands us to be chadosh as Yah. Does he command us? Then he must fashion us to do that and to walk in that kind of mindset, that kind of consciousness. Yahweh, Yah, is known by his mishpat, his judgment, which he asa, which he execute. The wicked, they're snared by their own works of their hands. We that are Yisra'iah, Yah constantly judge us, that he may fashion us into the image of Yahshua. And if he doesn't fashion us asa to do with us as he did with Yahshua, to accomplish in us what he accomplished in his Torah, Yahshua, the living, Zabah, the word of Yah. So it takes a correction and an order in order to fashion us. When one is being fashioned or groomed, as the world will say it, there is a rigor of courses that one must endure. One cannot just go out and say, I use this for an example, say, I'm a ballet dancer. You don't have the strength of your ankles, your legs, the endurance of your lung. It takes a process. It is one thing that a ballet dancer or a baseball player or a football player, one thing that they constantly do, they're constantly fashioning themselves. They're constantly practicing. They're constantly taking batting practice. They're constantly watching their diet. They're constantly running. They're constantly lifting. They're always doing those things to accomplish what their bodies, their purpose in that activity whereby they have applied themselves. And the reason that we are not being accomplished or we're not being fashioned, because we're not applying ourselves unto the Torah of Yah. When Yah judges us, we become irate. When he tells us things, we become distant from him. We become angry as a wicked dog out of hell. We defy Yah. We abandon his principles. And we began to seek things that will accommodate our own wicked, damn Baal, the Lord of our belly, our own damn wicked God. When someone instructs you in things that will discipline and strengthen you, it is the God of your belly that speaks out. It is the God of your will. It is the damn Baal that lords you and governs you that speaks out, and you will never get a damn thing accomplished, or you will never be fashioned in the way of Yah. It is one thing about the wise individual. They will always hear wise counsel. You speak to a wise man, he will become wiser. You speak to a wise daughter of Tizayon, she become wise. And you can tell one that is wise by what emanates out of them. You can tell when one is wise by the spirit that rests upon them. I don't care whether they're worldly, whether they are of Yah. You can tell when someone has something. You can look at someone and tell when they got it. And yet the people of Yah, the world can't look at us and tell we got the Enuot of Yahshua. The world can't look at us until we have the power of Almighty Yah. We have no power to pray, to lay hands, because we are tameh, we are filthy, we're dirty, our minds are dirty. Our minds are calculated to do evil and to practice evil. And it has no conscience of the evil that it practices. So Yah, first of all, he makes himself known unto us the Shabbaton, by correcting us all, to let us know where we have missed the mark. And we have missed the mark of the high calling of Yah in Yahshua HaMashiach. We're not pressing. I ask you the question, are you pressing? Don't lift your hand. Are you truly pressing? You're not pressing. We're pressing to do evil. We're pressing to do evil. We're pressing toward the mark of Yah. We're not pressing. And if we only any kind of press to do that, we get angry. We began to show our own nature. We're not pressing Yisrayah. We can deceive ourselves and say we are, but we are not pressing. We are full of deceit. We're full of lies. The weapons of Yah. The slaughtering arm of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. I want to read here in Gileana. I want to explain this to us as I read. Revelation chapter 16 and verse 13. These are the spirits that are gathering themselves together to make war with Almighty Yah. I'm the type of individual, when I see things, I will search all night until Yah give me, until He gives me some kind of clarity. That's me. That's my tenacity. I'm that way in everything I do. I don't care what it is. That's my nature. He put that in me, not me. And so when you read something like this, you just can't read it and brush over it. Yokahan says, as I was exiled on Patmos, he said, in this revelation of the time that shall be upon the Goim, the nations of the earth, the wicked, those that defy Yah, and the correction unto the house of Yisrayah. He says, I saw, my eyes were open. I could see literally, spiritually. I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, Hashatan, out of the mouth of this false, damnable beast, this system that we are under. I saw three unclean spirits come out of the power of governing of the minds of the people. I'm going to identify them. And if I'm wrong, then tell me I am wrong. He said, also out of the mouth of the pseudo prophet, the false men that say that they love Yah today. These false liars are bearers of lies and falsehood. I saw three unclean spirits. I saw them come out of this complex, of this military order to fight against Yah. He goes on to say, for they are the spirits of Shadim, of demons, of devils. These are unclean things. These are powerful beings. They have power to do what? They were spirits of devils working mighty or miracles. That's what they were doing. They could alter the conscience, the mind, the perception. They could alter the thought process. I will identify the spirits, all right? You just hold on. I know exactly where they are. And Yahshua spoke of these three unclean spirits. For they are three of the most vilest practitioners against Torah. He said, I saw those spirits. They began to work miracles. I like to use that Greek word, simio, when it comes to these miracles. Not the miracles of Yah, the Mofeth. I saw these beings, these devils, working miracles, which go forth to all, to the kings of the earth, and to the whole world. It did not say some of the world, but the whole world, to gather them to battle of the great day of Yah Almighty. That Hashatan, he's compiling his weaponry. He is spreading his military might, his power to every nation upon the face of the earth. We know that this battle is not something that is of a natural battle. It's greater than that, and yet it's a natural battle. And yet he saw these three unclean spirits to bring all the minds together, all the hearts together in a concise, precise effort to fight against Yah. Yet everything today fights against Yah. Everything. The lies of the pagan first day defying the Shabbaton, the Shabbat of Yah. The lies of this damnable Gentile Greek Latin named Jesus, Jesus, to deny the name of the HaMashiach of Yah. This damn wicked Christ, this vile, blatant, faggot image that was created in one of the most damnable, twisted minds upon the face of the earth. That name, I would abandon above all damn names. If I didn't know no name, I would not accept that name. My twisted, convoluted mind to tell you that this is HaMashiach, he is the Christo. No, he is the HaMashiach. He has the oil of Yah smearing on him. He just doesn't have any kind of oil on him, but he has the oil of Yah smearing upon him. Anyone can have the Christo or the anointed one, but he has the anointing of Yah. I saw the three unclean spirits that went forth to beguile the minds, to bring them all under the same ordinance of one law, for one purpose, and that is the fight against Yah. Even your babies fight against Yah today. Your little ones, how they are training them to fight against Yah. It's either you have the Ruach HaKodesh, or you have the three unclean. They are Tomei, they're vile, wicked spirits. And they're just like frogs, as the frogs of the plague of Mizraim, and we're in the land of Mizraim, and we sat on the river of the Euphrates. I will explain that. We know that one of the most prominent cities that sat on the river of Euphrates was Babel, the city of Babylon. And so we sat on the river of massive multitudes in this nation. There's every kind of nation and multitude of nations of people in this nation here, Yisra'iyah. And so we sat on the Euphrates. What was the Euphrates for? It was to import and to export what they call culture, and to carry it beyond the banks of the city of Babel. And there is where the city of Babel, she exploited the nations. Her spirit was introduced unto the nations of the earth. And so we sat on the river, on this vast metropolis of people, of all kinds of nations. And they're all injecting their will and their personality and their gods and their purpose and their desire. And we are feeding on this vile of what we think is health to our navel, and it's not health, Yisra'iyah. Three unclean spirits like frogs. And the frogs came upon the shores of Mizraim. They enter into the home of the royal. They enter into the court of the king. They entered into their kneading trough, that their bread was unclean. The bread we're eating is unclean, because it's mingled with unclean spirits. It's mingled with the three unclean spirits. It's mingled with the three unclean spirits. I'm going to identify them. Hallelujah. And so they enter into the kneading troughs, into the beds, into the bed chambers and everything. And it was only when the Pharaoh cried out, tell Moshe, tell Omar, I will let his people go. And yet the frogs began to remove themselves back into the waters where they belong. And yet many died, and it said that they not stink, but they stank. And that's the nature of us when we have those three unclean spirits. It is the mind to fight against Yah. It is the mind that draws from the weapons of darkness and try to manipulate Yah. And it stank. And when we're operating in a spirit that is not of Yah, we stink. You can smell the aroma. It's a stinking aroma. Our ways stink. Our attitudes stink. And we stink. He's making himself known by his mishpah unto us today. Hallelujah. Well, give us some kind of clarity on these unclean spirits that proceeded out of the mouth of Hashatan, the false prophet. Give us some kind of revelation of that. Well, I will speak it according to Yahshua. In the book of Yahkahanan, John. chapter 8. It's always there before you. We just don't read. Yochanan chapter 8, verse 44. Yahshua says unto those of the Pharisaic, of the order of law and Torah, and even unto us, he says, you are of your father. A son has the same nature of his father. He said, you are of your father. He calls him Hashatan. You're of your father, the devil. He begins to point out the very characteristics of Hashatan. He said, first of all, and the lust of the Avah, the lust of your father, your covetous nature, and Yah says that you should not covet. And so Hashatan, in his reprisal against Yah, he said, I will rise above the throne of Yah. I will exalt myself. I will be like the Most High. Did he not say that? And that's what we are trying to do, Yisra'iyah. We're trying to say, yeah, your judgment of your justice, it is not right. That is a very false spirit. That's why these damn bastard slips today. They're ordaining in this wicked nation where damn faggots can marry faggots. Where your children are being trained to assault Yah and say, how can you say it's wrong? They love each other. Hell, they don't know what love is. They don't know the nature of love. Yah's love. He said, first of all, the lust. He said, the lust of your father, the Avah, you are covetous. You're greedy. And that was Hashatan. He was covetous. He was greedy. He wanted what Yah had. But Yah says, you're going to be cast down to the side of the pit, you worthless child of hell. I made you. And that's our nature today. That is the power of these unclean spirits. It fights against Yah. What a man covets, he will fight against Yah. What a daughter of Zion covet for her own lust. And that's why the God of our belly, I will show you the description of that God. It is one that is covetous. It is one that it feeds on one's own greed and one's own lust. It is one that feeds on the self-grandizing nature of one. And we think highly of ourselves and think we possess something, but we don't. I saw three unclean spirits. Oh, it is simple to understand truth. When we apply ourselves, we give ourselves to seek after Yah. He said his first nature is one of lust. It's one of covetousness. You should not covet. You don't covet your neighbor's house, his wife, his ass. You don't covet nothing of your neighbor. He said, this is the nature of your father. And the lust, he is full of lust. I will show you that as I proceed, that you understand the weapons of Yah. Don't forget that lust now, that which is carnal. I said to my Israel the other day, I said, you know, I have been taught all these years what the word carnal mean. And I've just gone on that. And one night I was sitting in my house, it was late, and the word carnal just kept thrusting in my mind. And so I began to look at the true definitives of it. It's nothing what we've been taught. I will show us. That's why I say I want you to understand this word lust. The lust of your father, will you do? You tell me I will do the lust of your father, will you do? He first of all said that he was a rasach. He was a murderer. Yah commands us that we shall not murder. These are two of the most vile, unclean spirits. They're murdering your children. They're killing them in the womb of many. They're killing your baby's mind with internet, wall net, every kind of damn net and spider there is to draw your children onto this damnable delusion. And when Yah says you should not murder, you should not rasaka, he said you should not ever kill intentionally. There should not be a purpose. Well, I don't murder. When you hate, when you despise Yisra'iyah, your achot, and your ach, you are murderer. You are murderer. When you sell Yisra'iyah out because of the damn wicked god of your belly, you are a murderer. When you intentionally speak vile and ill against Yisra'iyah, you are a damn murderer. It is showing your sone, your hatred, your resentment. You are a murderer. There are two of the unclean spirits. We're going to deal with all of them. The lust of your father will you do. You're covetous. You covet. You covet the beauty of Yah. You don't want to do what it takes to bathe yourself in the righteousness of His Torah, but you're a covetous one and you exalt yourself. You exalt yourself beyond the very ordinance of His order. You say, that's not for me. See, your father is covetous. And that is one of the unclean spirits that goes out of HaShatan. He causes the world to covet. And everyone today is full of lust. Everyone today is covetous. Everyone covet after everything. They see someone got, they covet that. They see a little toy someone got, they covet that. They see this one got that, they want that. They see those things, they got to have that. It is an unclean spirit. It is a vile spirit. It is a vile, wicked thing. They covet today. They are covetous people. He said, and not only that, but they are rasak. They kill their brothers and sisters intentionally. The weapons of Yah, he is dressing himself as I read. You understand? He's putting on his weaponry, his armament. He's clothing himself for the great battle. They cause us to murder, to kill, to hate our brother and our sister without even a cause. You can't tell me you love me when there is no embracing. Your heart doesn't embrace me. When your heart is never concerned about me, you are a damn wicked, devilish, covetous liar. You are a murderer. You are a murderer. I know Yah loves me because He constantly, every second, correcting me. He chastised me. Out of their mouths is covetous. Children are so covetous. They see others. They want that. They put parents under such great pressure. They don't even know how to turn. Covetous. He said, they are rasach. They are murderers. The commandment commands us, the mitzvah, thou shall not rasach. You don't kill no man intentionally. You don't kill him to rob him. You don't kill your sister, your achot, your ach, robbing them of their beauty because of your slothful, wicked nature. You don't destroy their character because of your own unwillingness to be developed by the Torah of Yah. You don't desecrate a brother or a sister, a man of Yah, because of your own wickedness and destroy them. You don't do that. If we hate our brother, achot, ach, then we are murderers. You hate them. It is one thing about love. Does Yah embrace us? He embracing us today. He is showing us where we are, and in His heart to show us to get it right. And do it now. Get right with Yah, not tomorrow, now, and do it now. So He embraced us today to show us there are three unclean. They are vile. They are the antiphemus of every kind of vile action there is. There is nothing more vile that come out of the nature of one when they are covetous. When you find someone that is covetous and they covet and they're lustful, there's nothing more vile that comes out of that. Because it is one thing that it brings us to. It brings us to the laying in of the bed or in the sexual intercourse with every kind of vile thing it is. Just like the angels, they were melechim. When they looked upon the daughters of Tizayon and they saw that they were beauty, and they went into them and they produced something that was out of the order of the Ram of Yah. And that's what we're producing. We're producing thoughts that rise above the very order of Torah. We're producing this giant nature in us, thinking that we're not gonna have it your way, but my way. You're wrong. That's why His weapons are not carnal, not what we think worldly. I will show you what the word carnal means. I will read it out of the College Merriam-Webster Dictionary. I will show you what it means. Let me move on precisely. He says he was a murderer from the beginning, And then second, he did not abide in the truth. Why? Because there's no truth in him. And then his nature, when he speaks a lie, he speaks it of his own, for he is a liar from the beginning, or he is a liar and he is the father of that. He is one that speaks by the tongue of Shechar. What is a lie? It is what deceives and destroy our brothers and our sisters. Yah says that we should not bear false witnesses. See, that's the nature of a Shechar. And so this nation today, everything it witnessed as to be a loving nation and a kind nation, it is a false witness against Yah. You should not bear a false witness against your neighbor. He was a liar, he lusts, he was a murderer, and he was a liar. And all those spirits, it takes that unity to bring about a war. America lusts for the oil, for the greed of this nation and the lust. It is the nation that spoke lies to go over and to tear down a kingdom of Mr. Hussein. And it was a nation that coveted much for the things that were in that nation. The oil, the gas. And these are the three unclean powers or spirits that Yochanan saw. He literally saw the physical form of them. And they were like frogs. He saw them. The spirit of covetousness, of lust, the spirit of a murder. America murdered those babies in Iraq. They murdered babies in Afghanistan. They murdered babies in Pakistan. They murdered babies in Korea. They murdered babies in Japan. They murdered babies all over the world. They murdered babies in Africa. They brought the people of the diaspora and murdered their babies. Why? Because of covetousness. This nation was established by covetousness and murder and lies. And it's still alive today. You see a hell of a false assumption of the people. They were brought here in shackles and chains. This nation was not built on any kind of love for Yah. It was built on a love for the damn gods. That's why you got to come out of Bethel. Touch not the unclean things. You don't touch the damn things of the world. America was built on lust. She coveted the riches, the greed. So she enslaved, she brought those under bondage, even though Yah subdued the people to that. Because they were stronger than those that put them under bondage. They were stronger than those that put them under bondage. I don't take one damn word back. They were stronger than those that brought them and subjugate them unto laws that were inhumane, humiliating. They were stronger than them that they labored for. They showed a loyalty to them that beat them and separated their sons and their daughters and sold their babies to death. They were stronger than them. They had a greater might and a greater resolve than them that put them under the shackles of chains and bondage. They were mightier than them. And that is the truth. So this nation, it was built upon covetousness, lust. He said that unto those of Yisrael that say they knew Yah, and Yah say, you don't know me. He said, you're of your father the devil, and the lust, your father lusts. He covets everything that is royal unto Yah. He says, because he was a murderer, Rosaka, he intentionally killed. He killed without thought and without purpose. Don't we see that in this nation today? The streets are full of death. They kill without purpose. They covet one's tennis shoes or one's cheap watch, and they will kill for that. They covet the big screen television. They covet the material things. They murder, they kill without even purpose, Yisrael. This is the nature of the spirits in this nation to make battle against Yah. It is training your children, your sons, and your daughters to fight against Yah. You're giving and entrusting them to the world to train your sons and your daughters that they will abandon the ways of Yah. You've given them over to that. We have not trained our sons and daughters. We have not brought them up in the fear of Yah. And we might as well get real and acknowledge our ways and say, I was wrong because of my ignorance. And now you began to make haste. You redeem the time. You let your life be a pattern and example even unto them. I will not break the Torah of Yah because of you. You will get out of my damn face. You will stand. And having done all to stand in the street of Yah, you still stand still. I don't give a damn who offends. And so it calls us to kill, to destroy. And the spirit of Shechah, the lion spirit, there's nothing more pronounced among Yisrael. We say we love and we're full of lies. You embrace me and tell me you love me and you're full of a lie. It's one thing that I know. I can sense love from individuals. I know what is true love. I know what is a pretense. I know what is an association. Can't you men that are married, can't you sense something from your children when they embrace you? Are we not the children of Yah? I saw the three unclean spirits. This is the preparation of the battle against Yah. But he got weapons that's going to bring the house down. I'm going to show you his weapons as I proceed. He got weapons. He's going to bring the house down to desolation. He's going to bring it down. Three unclean spirits. One of great lust that is uncontrollable. Concupiscence. Without any control, we lust. We are not even conscious of our lust. We don't even think about our lust. We will do anything to satisfy the propensity of our lust. Something is sick in you. We will go beyond the beauty of our relationships to satisfy lust. We will lie. We will cheat to satisfy our lust. There are folks lying today to get credit cards. They cheat. They will do anything for a damn credit card to bring them under subjugation of the powers that be and to rule over them. That's why they give you one, because you've told a damn lie. They want you to have it because they're going to rule your house and they're going to rule you. And there are people that lie to get that. And what a wickedness it is. Again, I want to read that quickly. In Yochanan chapter 4, you have your father the devil. First of all, the avah, the lust, the covetousness of your father, what you do. He was a murderer because he was covetous. He murdered to try to get what he wanted. He said, you were a rasaka. He was a murderer from the beginning. He did not abide in the imata of the Torah of Yah because there's no power of Torah in him. When he speaks a shekah, a lie, he speaks of his own, for he is a liar. He's a liar, and he is the father of it. He shall perform mighty miracles that are mighty and great. The world has been deceived. We have been deceived by this one, the one that shall come. As Shaul speaks of, let me show you his identity here quickly in the book of Thessalonica. I'm sorry, the in the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 13. I want to read this quickly. Revelation chapter 13. Hallelujah. Revelation 13 and verse, hallelujah, verse 11 for expedience. Verse 9, quickly. Yochanan said, and I saw the great dragon cast out, that old serpent called the devil, Hashatan. That's what it says. I saw him cast out. It says, which deceived some of the world. Which deceived some of the world. Revelation chapter 13, verse, chapter 12, verse 9. Revelation 12, verse 9. He says, I saw him cast out, which deceive. He deceived what? The whole world. Was cast into the earth with his angels, were cast with him. And I heard a loud voice saying in the heavens, now is come salvation and strength, and the kingdom of our Abba, Yah, and the power of his Hamashiach, for the accuser of Yisrael, of Yisrael, he is cast down, which accused them before Yah day and night. Now they overcame him or the accusations by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their edut, their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. It gives us a stern warning here in verse 12. Then I want to go to Revelation 13. Therefore rejoice, you that are in heaven, you that dwell in the heavens. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for Hashatan is come down to you. And it says he's going to have what? Great what? Wrath. Now you got to have something that is powerful than his wrath. This is his weapon to fight. He's coming down with great wrath because he knoweth that he hath but a short time. And out of the bosom of Hashatan shall arise a kingdom, one that is political in power and one that has the power of religious worship. What nation is more religious than this nation? Every kind of religion is prominent in this nation. There is not a religion upon the face of the earth that is not practiced in Babel. There's not a nation that is on the great banks of Euphrates, of the populations of the earth that has, it has a variation of every nationality upon the face of the earth here, right in this nation. So there's no populace of people, as they call this, as diverse as in this nation, in other nations of the earth. And with that, you got every kind of God, every kind of twisted philosophy. It is, and out of that shall arise the magnificent one to seduce, to draw the people with great shekels. Have you ever lied to someone to deceive them? I'm guilty of that. Hallelujah. We're a bunch of pontificating hypocrites, are we not? Hallelujah. I've lied a many times, but the truth I speak to you, and I lie not in this. I don't lie to you in this. He says in Revelation chapter 13, hallelujah. Revelation 13, verse 11. He says, as Hashatan was brought down, I saw this beast, verse 11, come out of the earth, the Olam, and he had two horns. And those two horns, and if you search the Chatzveh, you will find that the horn of the ram's horn, the horn always represents strength, power of government. As we see with Achimrim, he blows the horn, the shofar, in always a call of religious service. That's what the horn represents. So he saw one, this one, that rise up, this powerful political being, the strength. What is more powerful than the political power of democracy? Can you tell me one other political power that's more powerful than what we call democracy? Have we not seen the nations crumble upon the face of the earth because people want democracy? They want their freedom of capitalism. They want to be able to satisfy their lust. I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth. I saw that, he said. And we see the unclean spirits today coming even out of our mouths. We're not satisfied with bread. We're not satisfied with clothing. We're not satisfied with the little, nor are we satisfied with much. The level of man can never be satisfied. Hell and the grave are never full, never satisfied. Neither can a heart of man be ever satisfied. That's why we need the heart, the mind, the love of Yahshua HaMashiach. I saw this beast rise up out of the earth. And he had two horns like a lamb. He looked as though that he was the one that would bring deliverance. He looked as though that he was the image of HaMashiach. But his power was based upon the political. And Yahshua denounced the political powers. He said, my kingdom, if my kingdom was of this earth, then yeah, I can call for a legion of Melechim. And they will fight for me. Hallelujah. So the weapons of Yah, they're mighty. We must understand his weaponry. And the only way that the powers that be, HaShatan is coming with great wrath. He's not going to be kind. Look at how he's breaking up the homes. Look how he destroyed the homes today. Look how he sell your babies to crack and cocaine and drugs and all this, these pharmaceuticals, these drugs today, the oxycodone and all of that. Look at your sons and daughters, how even I was reading it, I said to Oxymion the other day that they have a drug, a cocaine that's in New York that is literally eating, it caused the flesh to rot off. They're using the veterinarian type of chemicals to cut this drug with because people want it. Look at the young daughters and the women today are being hooked on this heroin that is free on the streets today. The pharmaceutical power of bewitching other minds. It's amazing that we believe a little damn pill will heal us. And yet the power of prayer doesn't do anything. It's amazing how damn intimidating, how damn wicked we are. We run to every kind of damn little pill that some wicked man has made. We don't bend our damn wicked, fat, wicked knees. All of us. Damn faggots laid hands on you. Damn poor daggers. I will, my friend. Every little damn pain we run, we're afraid. That is one thing that is not going into the kingdom, you that are fearful. It was a time that mothers would pray for babies. Now you're so damn fat and wicked and lazy, you don't know how to pray. The man don't have no goals to pray. I don't give a damn if you don't love me. He's judging his house. Judgment began first with us. And if it began with us, what shall be the end of them that believe not, trust not Yah? Hell, we don't know how to pray. We don't want men to try to enable our imuna. We'll speak against a man like that. But Pastor Robert just doesn't know. No, you're a wicked woman. You're a wicked man. You don't know. You trust in the arm of flesh. Curse to be every man that trusts in the arm of the damn flesh. I don't know. You're trusting your damn doctors. You're trusting their pills. They get you hooked. Your babies are deformed. I was reading an article the other day that 250,000 people are killed every year in the doctor's office. Malpractice. You don't hear a damn thing. No doctor gets sued. There was ever. But if one wait by Imona for Yah, they will arrest them. Hallelujah. We got to become bold as a lion. Harmless as a dove, we got to become bold. It's what they got a dove. He's harmless, but when you get close to me, we'll fly off. We can soar above. I'm preaching this right today. Hallelujah. Whether you bow or not. Hallelujah. He appeared to be like the lamb, but he spoke like the dragon. And he exercised all the power of the first beast. He exercised all the mannerism of Hashatan before him. And he caused the earth. He caused the olam. This has always fascinated me. This has always caused my mind to ponder this matter. He causes the earth and them that dwell in, first of all, to worship the first beast, whose deadly wounds was healed. You go to worship of this Babylonian system that is restored. That's what people are worshiping today. Is that not the rush of them? Is that not the heads? Is that not the head of the people today? That they want, they're full of lust, they will lie, and they will kill. And that is the nature of YHWH. We're full of lust. We will lie at the drop of a hat. We have no fear of lying. We will murder. We will kill our hope with no conscience at all. We will say that which is evil is tav, and that which is tav is evil. You are an abomination unto Yah. You will speak against a messenger like Raah Dawid YisraYah, and men that speak with truth, and you will uphold the hands of the wicked ones. You will strengthen them. They will talk that damn Jesus talk, and you're not offended. I'm offended at that damn Jesus talk. Hallelujah. Damn that Jesus talk. I talk the word of Yah. I speak that damn your Jesus talk. You may be a coward, but I am not. Hallelujah. He has no damn pagan Gentile name. He has no Latin equivalent. He has no damn Greek equivalent. Damn the Greek equivalent. I don't give a damn what we've been taught all our lives. You were taught that Christmas was right. You were taught that rabbits lay eggs. You were part of Easter egg hunts. Talk to me, Yisra'iah. You know it's the truth. You were taught to lie. It was all right with a damn white lie. That's who taught you how to lie, the damn white mind. I'm not taking it back. Damn the white mind. Damn it. Damn that wicked mind. Hashatan says, the Yahshua, you bow down, you worship me. For the earth is mine. Whomever I want to give it, I give. Whomever I want to make rich, I can. I just ask you to bow down and worship me. I use that mind because that is a mind that purely worships Hashatan. It is the white mind. Because a man's pigmentation may be cream, that doesn't mean he's a damn white man. And if you identify yourself as white, you're damn wicked. I don't give a damn who you are. You protect the white mind, you're a damn wicked beast. That is the mind that taught you what worship was. That is the mind that has taught the world. You sit here like hypocrites because you're intimidated. You sit here like hypocrites because you're afraid. You sit here like hypocrites because you want to defend the damn white mind. Damn the wicked white mind. It is that mind that caused and showed you how to aggressively acquire your own lust. I will. Hallelujah. It transcends every kind of ethical bounds. Every kind of what you call culture. Hell, I don't know what culture is. People create little things they do and they call that culture. Because you can dance, you can shake your booty, you can do that. That's culture. You can sing. Hell, that's not culture. Not to me. If that's culture, then why culturate the children to be as wicked? Hallelujah. So it is that white mind. That's why I use that. It was the white mind established in America that was depraved and wicked, a butchering, killing, wicked, lustful, lying mind. It was a mind that lied to people to say it's all right for you to be slaves because you're lesser. You're not of the humankind. Hell, I don't want to be of the humankind. That simply implies that you're kind of a human. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so I sought that damn wicked mind. There's nothing more vile than the white mind. There's nothing more corrupt. You find that mind everywhere. You find it on the continent of Africa, Asia. It makes no difference whether the eyes are slant or they're black as tar. You find that wicked white mind, the mind that is superior over Yah, the mind that says this is what Yah meant. When Yah says, Zachaha Shabbat, remember the Shabbat and keep it, Shema Chadosh, the wicked white mind says it's first day, it is Yom Rishon. It taught you, it taught me that this is right. It has gone out to the world through the power of the missionary power. As that one beast that rose out of the earth, he had two horns. One that is of a political agenda and persuasion. And every last one of these damn wicked preachers today, they got them on television getting their political discourse of dissent about everybody. You will never hear them say that this is a wicked nation. America is a vile, wicked slut. She is a whore. She is a pedophile. She rob and rape and intercourse your babies. They intercourse them on television. Your little babies are feeling freaky at 3 and 4 and 5. They're shaking their ass like a beast in the field. They rob your babies. They serenade this continuous avalanche of wicked whores, freaks, singing to their minds. And they rob them of any kind of beauty as a child. And we are so ignorant as hell, and we are so wicked and cowardice. We don't have the backbone or the courage to stand up for Yah. Stand up for him. We never be a partaker of any man's wickedness. Don't be partaker of another man's sin. Don't covet their sins. Don't covet their wickedness. You never become a partaker of another man's sin. Saw this one rise out of the earth. It caused the whole earth, verse 12, them that dwell on earth to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. The nation, this nation, from afar, people worship this nation, doesn't it? I don't care where you go. They can't even read or write, but they've heard about America. It's the land of promise, the land of opportunity, the land of great hope. And yet, when they get here, they find it is a land of depravity and death, destruction. And yet her economy looks as though that she is faltering and has failed during the Great Depression. Yet her wounds were healed. She rose up. The great city of Bethel, she rose up. She became prominent in the industrialized revolutionizing of this nation and the world. And now she's a sick, dirty whore. She's laid upon her bed, and nobody gives a damn about her. Her lovers have gone into her. They have robbed us, taken from us, robbed you of your resources. And hell, you don't even have the heart and the kindness. We don't as a nation to look after Yisrael, to take care of the widows and to take care of those that have not. We don't even have the resources to do one thing at all, because she has taught us how to be covetous. We're greedy as hell. We give and we want it back. We give and we take back. We don't give a damn thing. We give looking for something. We give expecting something. You give and expect nothing. You don't give and expect something. If you give from your heart, you don't expect nothing back. That's the way we have been taught. I give you some of my candy, you give me some of yours. No, just give me some candy. That's how you do it. Hallelujah. It says in verse 13, and this beast, this powerful anti-Hamashiach, this dragon, this pseudo-false one of hell, and he does great wonders. The wonders are so magnificent. The miracles are so great, verse 13, that he makes fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And he deceives them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he has power to do in the sight of the beast. We see this beastly religious system called Christianity. We see the damn beast of the pseudo false liars of deceptions of Shekel, like the Benny Hens. We see those men like the T.D. Jakes. We see the men like the Eddie Longs, and they are always praying and saying that they are performing miracles. And yet folks say they're healing all that. And people come from all over the world for these liars, so they can lay their hands on them. They come from every corner of the world to come and see these damn wicked men. This is the power of this religious worship beast system. And they're false damn miracles. There is no damn miracle outside of the name and the power of Yah. There is no miracle in the name of the damn Jesus. You're liars. They're liars. The damn liars. Yah's going to fight. He's already clothed with his weapons. He's going to bring it down to the gates of hell, son. I'm going to destroy this wicked mess. You don't compromise with Yah. You find this beast spirit today, this religious beast, it is more prominent in what we call Christianity than any other form of religion. That they come to this nation, and they come for the healing. They come to be prayed over in the name of their Christo. Hallelujah. And Yah commands us for us to cleanse ourselves and to be clean. And then we confess our sins. They begin with confessing our faults one unto another. We will not confess. We will have this murdering spirit against our sister or our brother. And we will not even tell them. You are a coward of a beast. We confess our faults one unto another. And the fervent righteous prayer of a righteous man, or the prayer of a righteous man, the fervent prayer of a righteous man, the Sadiq man, availeth much. If we have all, if there's nothing in our heart against our achot, our ach, then we lay our gift down. And we get it right, and then we come before the altar. That's, we are very dirty, we are very unclean. That's why Yah says in this day, you can't even trust in a friend. Well, Yah, I know what you said, but I'm going to trust my friend. Yahshua said he's my friend, isn't he? Is he your friend? Then you're my friend then. Hallelujah. He said, I call you no more servants, but friend. Because the servant knows not what his master does. But I reveal unto you all things that I do. He said, you're my re'ah. You're my re'ah. You're my friend. No greater love than this, that a friend, that a man, that a brother, a sister will lay down their lives for Raah. He's my friend. Hallelujah. And if you're his friend, you're my friend. We are shallow people because sin has handicapped us. Our own iniquity has made us not even the value of a dumb ass, because a dumb ass knows his master's crib. We don't even know the Most High because we despise his judgment. He had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them in verse 14, he deceived everyone. I'm down here where it says, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that you should make an image to the beast which had the womb by the sword, and now it does live. You must make this image. And America is the image of the beast of the Medo-Persian, the Babel Empire, the Roman Empire. She is that image of that. And she has been resurrected out of every kind of chaos. She has stole. She has coveted. She has lust. She has been one of the most proliferator of death. All she knows how to do is build to kill. I was reading an article this morning that America, our illustrious president, Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, is sending drones onto Somalia. Hell, the people, their land has been destroyed by the British, the Angloids, their waters have been contaminated, whereby a people were inking out lives of simplicity, fishing off their shores, and these dirty seed of the bastard slips come and dumping their toxicity in their waters to kill off the coral reefs, the fishing, whereby people fish every day and they lived well. They had fish. Now they could not fish. And so the men said, to hell with you wicked Americans and you world powers. We're going to take what you have taken from us. And they began, as they classified them as pirates. Well, who are the greatest pirateering or done the greatest pirateering in the world? This nation. It robs, it steals, it kills. And yet it does not hold itself to the same standard of judgment as it holds others. And we don't hold ourselves to the standard of the judgment of Torah as we hold others to the standard of the judgment of Torah. We make provisions for ourselves, but I'm telling you that is an evil, that is an unjust judgment that you possess. It is not the true judgment of Almighty Yahweh YisraYah. It is wrong. It is wicked. It is vile. And we're going to pay a price for that. And we can see this nation, we can see this beast, this political power, this religious power that has arisen in this nation. And we can see that how the worlds and the world leaders, they bow down to the head of this nation. Every world power, I don't care who it is, they bow down to the world leaders of this nation here. This nation. We can see the relics of the religious construct in every nation of what we call Christianity. You can see it in the Hindu world. They celebrate the Christmas, the Mass, and all of that. You can see it everywhere. You can see from the shores out of the belly of this Roman horde, this religious order that has arisen, and her strength is not in Rome, because the motives for that come from this wicked nation. And yet she has spread her tentacles throughout the world and got people bound down before some damn wicked statues and praying to these damn gods and these faggot popes and these faggot cardinals raping their babies. And yet people want to send their children to a Catholic school. What a damnable, twisted mentality. You teach them yourself. You teach your babies what's right and wrong. You bring them up in the fear of Yah. That's what you do, Yisrael. You don't leave the wicked to train your children. That's wrong. Hallelujah. Giving your babies into the hands of the wicked to train your babies. That's not how you do it. You don't even know those people. You don't even know their lies, but that's what you're doing. The weapons of Yah, the slaughtering weapons of Yah. Shaul speaks so delicately here in the book of 2 Corinthians. I would begin here in verse 4, chapter 10, verse 4. He talks about the the armament, the weapons. For the weapons of our warfare. See, of our warfare. 2 Corinthians 10, 4. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not shechaba. They're not carnal. I have always been taught that the word shechaba, or carnal, meant that we are worldly. But the indication of its meaning, it has a more grave indication of even its etymology, what it derives from. And this was the only word carnal what shechaba could be associated with. And I will show you scripture that comply with this. I want to define, first of all, this act of what we call carnal. I want to pause there. I want to stop there for a moment. For the weapons, the telpia, the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. And every Merriam-Webster dictionary or the New World Dictionary, this is what carnal is. This is, it's definitive. This is what it means. It means this. Carnality ought to be carnal. Is marked by sexuality, sex now. This is what it is, sexuality. There is no indication of the word carnal that implies worldly. It is marked by sexuality that is often frank, that is crude, and unrelieved by the higher emotion. Now, that's what carnal is. That in order to satisfy the carnal desire, it is relieved by the application of this sexual action. Everything in this nation is sexual, isn't it? They sell you cookies with naked women, don't they? They sell your baby little toys with dirty, filthy whores stripped down to their drawers. They sell you everything with these effeminate faggot men. Their chest is bare and they're naked. Talk to me, YHWH. This is how the enemy established this carnal mind in the people of Yah. It is the sexual intercourse with the religious powers. You don't lay in bed with religious concepts that are not based upon Torah. I'm reading what the word carnal means. It's not how I define it. Bodily in relationship, that's what sex is. There must be a bodily contact, but I was taught as a young man, carnal mean worldly. No, this is not just worldly here. Bodily contact in relationship, it indicates concentration on bodily satisfaction and absent of anything intellectual or spiritual. Often it implies gross sexuality. That's what it implies. So we see the carnal nature of this nation. Everything is sold by some kind of illicit sexual act, some kind of uncontrolling sexual act. I don't see how people can subjugate their children to the control of the masters of hell, to train their minds and give them. Every child got a television in their room and they're doing their own little thing. Mama is wicked, daddy, no one has no conscience of Yah to say something is wrong. If this is controlling all of my time, it takes my time. I fall before this. I'm always thinking about it. Come on. There are those that think about a ball game before they think about their wife and their children. There are those that the first thing on their mind is sitting down there watching as the whores turn another trick than to prepare food for their husband. There are those that sit there and watch Ryan lies of hope And yet they do not create any hope in the bosom of their ish, showing how satisfied they are with God. They will sit there all day, house nasty as hell. It's not even clean. They won't even wash their own buttock. They stink. They sit there all day and just flip, flip, flip. We'll not even get up and clean the house. Hell, we were poor. We didn't have much, but my grandmother knew how to boil pine, green pine cones and things like that to keep the house smell. The house smell pissy and dungish. It's unclean. You know something is twisted in your damn mind. Everything on that thing, riding your hope, is it about carnality? Is it all about sex? Talk to me, YisraYah. Even as a young boy, I remember that. I never did watch that damn mess. I have watched it, but that's what it's all about. Are all those shows about sex? I was in the garden the other day. We were talking about pate and place. I said, you know what? Without the control of Yah, or the wisdom of Yah, then this place will be just like a pate and place. Everybody's sleeping with everybody. Everybody doing their thing. And they're training your sons and daughters to be carnal. That's why they have no power and sense of the weaponry of Almighty Yah. We are so carnal, we're inundated with sexuality and sex. The women, their titties out. The men are bare and everything. No shame today. They don't even cover themselves. My body's for my Yahshua. Her body's for me to look at. For me to see her breast. For me to enjoy that. For her to enjoy my chest and the nakedness of my body. It's not for every woman to enjoy, to look upon. And I want my chest open that you can look out and see my pectorals. I want her to see that. This is what carnal is. It's preparing the minds for a sexual habit or a habitual sexual act. And that's all this religion is. Satisfy the drive of the flesh. It's not just a worldly thing. It is a sensual sexual thing. And everything from morning to night, they fill the mind with sexual things, don't they? Is that what the soap operas are about? You that are listening to this broadcast, you know what I'm talking about. That's what they're all about. I don't care what time of the day. I don't care whether she's a police or what. She is sensual and sexual. I don't care whether you go buy a calendar, they're naked. Your son or your daughter wants to buy a toy, there's a naked woman there. Even in the games that they play, the women with the big blown up titties and they're naked, they're fighting crime and they're naked like a dog. Everything is sensual there. They are playing on the minds of your children through this form, this power, the weaponry of Hashatan, because he has wrath against you. He has wrath against the Olam. He has wrath against Yah. He is not coming with the sweet word. He's coming with wrath, with hell and destruction to kill your babies, to abort them, to destroy them. He's destroying their minds today. It is systems of captivity, your schools that you put your babies in. You take them off your titty. You put them in these schools with strangers. Because you just don't give a damn. You don't even care. You wonder why they're twisted. Because you're twisted, mama. Daddy, you are the damn fool. That's why the boy acts like a damn fool. Because you are a damn fool. You think it's going to give him some kind of progression. It makes him twofold the child of hell. He becomes even more rebellious. He does even more wickedness. Hallelujah. We can see that her system is not even promoting them today. Because they're graduating from college, $100,000, $200,000 debt. And they cannot get jobs. And that's a fact. Hallelujah. I think I'll take $100,000. Give me $100,000. I can show you what I can do with it. I can show you. I can show you the great works I can do with $100,000. I can show you that. Hallelujah. 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 It is sensual. It is often sexual. It implies gross sexuality may simply indicate, it is only one indication of it, it is gratification of any bodily desire or pleasure that derive from the sensual sexual desire. Would a man satisfy his sensual desire, everything? Would a man finish an act like that? He's not ready to just jump up and eat a steak. He has satisfied his proclivity, his desire, his purpose, his strength is abated and everything. That's why we have no strength today. The weapons are not carnal. They're not carnal. Well, how is our minds being trained today? With internet, everything on the internet is sexual today. I don't care where you go, it is sexual, everything. Even on the Ustream, they stream their sexual advertisement and all of that. Even as we broadcast. Or they tell you you can have it free, but we're going to do this unless you pay us money. And so you have to pay up in order. And there are those that are looking today and being blessed, and they won't send one damn brown penny. So we can't do that. It's a sad shame. It is. We're not beggars, but your house has been enriched. I don't care if it's $1. You sent it. Hallelujah. You sent something. We don't have money. You have money for every damn thing else. Don't buy the potato chips this week. Hallelujah. That's what you do. For our weapons are not carnal. Again, in Corinthians, for the weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal, but mighty through Yah to the pulling down of metzats. Of the stronghold, the forts, the fortresses that rise up against us. I try to, in all the effort that Yah grants unto me, there's only one thing that's going to give us the strength to resist the weaponries of this world, only one thing. There's only one thing that is better than the weapons of Hashatan, only one thing. I will read that in Kohati, Ecclesiastes. Hallelujah. If you remember nothing of this message today, you remember this. There's only one thing that is bona fide. And the greatest access we have as Yisra'iyah, that's what we must hear the Torah and learn. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 18. This is it. It says, Chuchmah, wisdom. The power to understand the spiritual elements of war. Wisdom is better than any weapons of kirab, of war. Of the armament of darkness, we need the wisdom of Almighty Yah. Wisdom is better, but a sinner, a chata, destroys much tov. That's what a sinner does. What is a sinner? One that blatantly practices defiance of the Torah. You hear the truth, you know it's right, and then you don't obey that. That's a sinner. You that know to do right and do it not, it is a sin. You know it's right to do what the Torah commands you, and yet you do not do it. In order for us, we must be wise as a serpent. We must have the wisdom, the chokhmah. We must be able to discern in the spiritual battle that we are in. It is better than the weapons of this battle that Hashatan has. He has all the media. He controls everything. And he is trying to play on the mind that is without wisdom. That is why the enemy keeps us away from anything that will produce the consciousness of Yahshua in us. That's why we don't like to study Torah. We don't like to read. We don't like to gravitate. We'll gravitate to folly. We'll gravitate to every kind of silly thing. But when it comes to Yah, we will not gravitate. We will not come to the light, the awe of His Torah. We don't get satisfied with Torah. We want to talk about something else. When someone talking about Torah, we become antsy. We become nervous. We become unsettled. We will, how much more time she's going to talk? We're ready to run because of our own damn wicked nature. She's, that's what a child does, doesn't it? And you as adult, we as adult, we perform the same damn way. We may not do it in a physical sense where it's known, but you do it in your spirit, Yisra'iyah. You don't want to hear about that. You don't delight in that. And that's why we are dumb as hell. We're ignorant. My people are destroyed because they lack God. We lack the knowledge of Yah. We don't know how to use wisdom. We got to get wisdom that is better than the weapons of war. We got to understand how Yah's going to fight this battle. We got to understand that you can't use no laser beams to knock out HaShatan. It's got to be something greater than that, Yisrael. You're not using your emotions to bring him under. It's got to be something that is mighty. How is he coming to fight against us? He's coming with wrath, isn't he? So in order for you to fight against someone that's coming with wrath, you got to know what wrath is. You got to have wrath too. You don't know the weapons of Yah. We don't know anything because we don't want the wisdom of Yah. It's not that was expressed to us in Gileana. He's coming with great wrath. He's coming with great wrath. How do you fight against that? How do those little poor people over there in Afghanistan fight against the bombs dropping and those stealth bombers and those bombs dropping on their home? How do they fight against that? With a little 22 pistol? With a machete or a rock? How do they fight against that? How does one, when they don't even see that drone gets 5 miles in the air, they can't even hear it? It locks down on the house, locks down on your family, and that missile falls. And you know nothing until it hit. How do you fight against that? How do we fight? For the weapons of Yah, they're not carnal, they're not sensual. And this is what the enemy is doing. He's driving our minds in a sexual, sensual fashion. That's why young men today, they're driven by their lust. They can't wait and hold fast. Young daughters today, it's just a sensual thing. It's a sexual thing. They're pressed on every side, Yisrael. That's why we as a nation, we must come out. You have your own television station, you have your own, and you promote that which is of Yah, and train your daughters and your son. The world is training you. The babies know how to bump before they even know what a bump is. You take them in these stores, your little babies, and that music that is playing, and watch how they were moving. Watch how they will cut it. Hallelujah. Demons pressing against them to enter into their little minds. Hell, mama not prayed up, and daddy is phony as they come. What do you expect? Hallelujah. Daddy is not real, and mama is a Jezebel, and daddy is worse than a Jezebel. He's false as hell, and she's worthless, and he is not even worthless. He's opened up his house to every kind of strange spirit, every kind of wicked thing that is imaginable to the mind. His weapons are not carnal. The weapons of Yah, they are not carnal. And that's what everything featured today. You go in the religious houses, are they not carnal? Are the women coming in that so sensual? Are they not dressed like dirty whores? Come on, Yisrael, they're dressed like sluts. They're walking in there with dresses on up to here. This would be a dress to many of them right here where my jacket come right there. That's a dress to many of them. That's what carnal is. That's what sensuality and sexuality is. You cannot develop the mindset of the weapons of Yah with that kind of continuous bombarding and entertainment. You can't do that. So the enemy has set up the televisions to entertain your mind all the time to that degree. You can't look at a commercial. I don't look at commercials. I don't know what's on there, but I know what's on there because I've looked at television. You can't look at a commercial without some sensual, sexual, some grossly inundating of sexual messages. That's all it is. That's all it is. That's all it is. You say what you want to. Hallelujah. Hell, I've spent enough time in my life watching television. If I never watch it again, I'm all right. I spend my time serving Yah, loving him, and understanding what Torah says. Hallelujah. Because I know I'm going to die. You may not die, but I'm going to die. I'm going to leave this world. Hallelujah. And I'm preparing for that. Hallelujah. Don't worry about burying me. I don't care how you bury me. Put me in a box. Let the body rot the way it's supposed to rot. Hallelujah. Don't embalm me. You all know better than that. Put me in a pine box and let the body rot the way Yah intended for it to rot. Don't try to preserve nothing. The dead know nothing. This old body won't know a thing. And nothing I won't know. Let it rot. We came from the dust. Let it go back. Even mine defies that. Let it rot. Let the skin worms, as Eob said, eat my flesh. Let them consume it. Hallelujah. That's why we got so many diseases today. They're embalming these bodies and the leaching of that. You should never. You let the body rot. You know, there are people that get afraid about that because they think that that old dirty stinking body is going back to the maggots. Maggots are going to eat it. The maggots, the flies are going to, within minutes when you die, the skin worms, the maggots are created. Ain't nothing. It's filthy. There's no tough thing in this stuff here. Nothing. Hallelujah. We need wisdom, YHWH. Wisdom, the spiritual application of fighting the spiritual battles is better than weapons of war. It is better. It is better than weapons of war. See, that is a spiritual application of Yah. It is his mind. The wisdom of Yah is his thoughts, his concepts. Even the battle against HaShatan, we have an adversary that is real. And he fights against the integrity of Yah from the beginning. He rose up because of his own pride to overthrow the very dynamics, the beauty and the majesty of Yah, thinking that if I leave him, he will have no more covering for his beauty. But he had it all in the whole, if I must say, because it was his beauty that resonated from the beauty of the Most High. And so he gave one that was had no comeliness or no sensual attraction that many would be allured to, Yahshua, that covered the Almighty Yah. His word is what covers him. It is his imat that what covers him. That's why man can go to prison and die in the gas chamber knowing that he did not commit the crime. It is the truth that covers that man's conscience. It is the man that knows that he has not done the act or the deed that he has been accused of. It is truth of the matter, the situation that covers his conscience. And he doesn't die with any shame. He doesn't die with shame. Hallelujah. I want to show you this example of what the scripture, when it uses this word, carnality, a carnal, just one verse of the Shechaba, is here in the book of Weyira, Leviticus 18:20. You got to search the Chatve to understand. You got to have line and line precept here. You just can't read from a few chapters and think you're going to get clarity. It doesn't work that way. I search the book from Bereshit to Revelation all the time. I will go through at times 200 verses until I come across the one that I know that burns a fire in my bosom, and I read them. Hallelujah. This is what this act or this ishechaba, carnality, a carnal. Leviticus 18:20, moreover, you should not lie carnally. Does it say that? Carnally with your neighbor's wife to defile her. That's what carnality is. You shall not covet. It is the spirit of covetousness. It is the sensual, sexual drive. And that's what the world is doing today. They're making you covet every woman that you see because it is ingrained in this in your mind, Yisrael. It burns this wickedness in your mind. It burns that zira in your mind. The seed is planted there. Even Shirach says, man, when you see a shapely woman, don't even look upon her. You see her, turn your head quickly. You don't even look upon a shapely woman. You find yourself with this carnal nature. That's why Yahshua say, no, it's not just one lie with the woman that commit adultery. But if a man looks upon a woman and left for her, that man has committed a carnal sin against Yah. You don't even look at a woman in lust for. That's why the daughters, the Baptist, they dress in a way that no man will look upon them. They want them. You don't want to look upon an ox wife in lust for her. It's wrong. You don't covet his wife. And they're doing that today. And the gatherings of the wickedness is one thing that is certainly to be carnal minded, to have that sensual lust mind. It is death. But to be spiritually minded, it is life and shalom. When you're carnal minded, your sons and your daughters, they're dead in the lust of their flesh and the carnal covetousness. They have no sensitivity, Yah. You can talk until your head blows up and explode. It's not going to change them. Yah has respect to person. He had respect unto Yaakov offering and not Esau. He had respect unto Abel and disrespected Cain. And that's a fact, Yisra'yah. That's what it is. It's the sensual drive. The enemy is preparing our minds for carnal battle. We must understand how the battle is fought, that we will not become discouraged. What are the weapons of Yah? I want to begin here. I want to read this quickly out of the book of Wisdom. Wisdom chapter 5, verse 16. Hallelujah. And Shlomo speaks of this great battle of Yah and his weapons. And he speaks against this wicked power and the wicked one. HaShatan is the wicked one. We see what translates in the spiritual, it translates in the natural. And the wisdom of Shlomo speaks here in Wisdom 5:16. He said, therefore shall they, and the day they, that's us, Yisra'yah, we're going to receive a splendid melchut, a kingdom. He says, and a tefarah, a beautiful crown, from his hand. He is going to give that unto Yisra'yah. For his right hand, Yahshua, he shall cover them. Does not the dam of Yahshua cover our sins, his blood? It covers us. He is the right hand of Yah, shall cover us. And his arm shall he protect Yisra'yah. Yah says, I'm going to do that. He says, I want you to understand Yahweh shall take to him his jealousy for complete armor and make the creature his weapon, his keli, for revenge on his enemy. He shall put on the righteousness as a breastplate, his Torah, and his true impartial judgment and justice instead of a helmet. He's going to put on his righteous covering of Torah. Yahshua is the covering of Yah. It is his words. And his breastplate, Yisra'yah, his judgment is impartial. We know when our judgment is impartial, it is not the judgment of Yah. We judge our brother of our natural descent different than we judge our brother of the Ruach. Something is twisted in you. When you judge your sister, her actions different than you judge anyone else, something is wrong, Yisra'yah. You know you don't even have the wisdom of Yah to understand the weapons of Almighty Yah. This is how he is going to keli. He's going to dress himself. He's going to dress himself. And once he dresses himself, he's going to pull out his weapons, all right? He's going to dress himself this way. He said, I am impartial. I don't care who you are. I don't give a damn. You're guilty. She is not guilty. He is, and he is not. His judgment is impartial. It is a true judgment. And our judgment is impartial. It's very impartial. And it's wicked. We will cover even the wickedness of our own, yet you will not even cover even the shameful sin of your true ach or achot. Something is wrong in your heart. You all have heard this many times, and it still doesn't change your heart. He that is often reproved, stiffen his neck. You harden your heart. And Yah says, because of that, then destruction comes upon them, and that is without warning. He's not going to even warn. He's not even warning us no more, because he's spoken unto Yisra'yah. And we still defy him. His breastplate is not false like ours. We don't have on the breastplate of Sadiq. Our loins are not girded with the truth of Yah, his Torah. Our hearts are not overtaken with Torah. We don't delight in Torah. We don't rejoice in Torah. We have no sword that we use to cut and fight against the wicked, which is the Torah of Yah. And take the sword of the Ruach, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of Yah. We don't even know the word of Yah. We don't even want to hear it. We don't even have no shield of our mind to guard us against the spiritual warfares of hell. We have no faith. We don't trust Yah. We don't trust Him when there's a pain. We don't trust Him when there's sickness among us. You don't trust Him. Where are the praying mothers to teach the young daughters how to pray? They're raising hell and busybodies. Where's the standard of the strong man that know how to lay in sackcloth before Yah? He's full of his own damn covetousness and lust. He's greedy, sitting around doing not a damn thing. Where are the mighty men? Where are the warriors of David? Where are they? I will, my friend. Where are they? Where are the warriors of Dawid? Tell me. I'm going to teach on that one too, all right. Where are the warriors? You don't have anything. Because the men are not protective of the home. They're not protecting the wares of Yah. Hallelujah. They don't know how to be forthright and straight and plain honest. His judgment is impartial. It's not a weak judgment. Hallelujah. He says, he shall take... Kadosh or Kodash for an invisible shield. That's our shield. It's good thing about Imuna, it is invisible. And his faith, his Imuna, it is Kadosh, it is Kodash. He said, this shall be the shield of Yah, it's invisible. His severe wrath. You understand how is HaShatan coming? The one that shall come in the same power of HaShatan, he's coming with what? Wrath, isn't he? And Yah says, his severe wrath, not just any kind of wrath, but his Ibrah, that only describes the wrath and the indignation of Yah. His severe wrath shall be sharpened for a sword. You see, that is his sword. For us, it is the sword of the Ruach, his word. Yah says, my severe wrath is going to be sharpened as a sword. And the world shall fight with him against the unwise. Then shall the right aiming thunderbolt, the true light of his Torah, go abroad. And from the cloud, as the cloud followed them by day that led them, and a pillar of fire by night, the thunderbolt led Yisrael. As from the well-drawn bow, shall they fly to the mark. He is not missing one. He hasn't missed us today, and he is not going to miss us. He hasn't missed our corruption, our sins. He has spoken unto Yisrael. You cannot hide anything from him. He sees everything we do, and you're not getting back. He is in the midst because I came in his name. And if you did, there are two or three. We gather in his name, and there shall he also be in the midst. Yah says that my hellstorm. Have we seen the hellstorms around here? I saw one other day as the hell fell. We've seen the hellstorm. He says, and the hellstorm full of wrath shall be cast as out of a stone. And the waters of the sea shall rage against the wicked, the unwise. We have seen that. We have seen that in Joplin, Missouri. We see it all over. We see the rage of the Mississippi. We see that how the waters are raging. Yah says, I'm pulling out my weapons now. You that are wise, you that are skillful in war, you will know that these are my weapons. Hallelujah. He say, and the floods shall cruelly drown them. You tell me Yah is cruel? That's what he says. Is he full of compassion? And yet he said that the rage of the flood shall cruelly. It shall be cruel. It's going to drown the babies. It's going to drown the mamas. It's going to kill the daddies. It's killing grandmama, the old, the cripple. Those that are unwise, whose mind have been shaped to fight against Yah, whose hearts have been turned And as the world, that's where we have the sensitivity for the world. We will defend the world. We will defend the actions of the wicked. We will. Our wicked sons and daughters can turn their backs on Yah, and we want to embrace them and hear from them, damn them. You all don't know me. Honestly, you don't. You think you know me in the fullness of this matter, man, but you really don't know what kind of man I am. I'm not a shallow man like that. They have laid their hands to the plow. They have turned their back. They're not fit for the kingdom. They are trodden under the foot of Dharma, of Yahshua HaMashiach. You think that Yah's going to embrace them? You're liars. You're damn liars. You can pray all you want to. Your prayer doesn't mean a damn thing. You don't even pray for yourself. That's why we are wicked. That's why we have no shame in our actions. And yet you won't even pray for the messengers and those that are the house of Yisra'iyah. You will pray for the wicked and those that blatantly defy Yah. Those that have disdain for Yah, and yet for Yisra'iyah, don't pray for me, you damn hypocrite. Don't pray for me. Don't waste your breath praying for me. Hallelujah. It makes no difference. We're guilty of that. We're guilty. We're guilty. Hallelujah. We pray for the wicked, but we'll not pray for the Sadiq. Yes, a mighty wind shall stand up against them, and like a storm shall blow them away. Why? Thus, because of the Torah-less iniquity, shall lay waste the whole earth, because they will not abide in the Torah of Yah. Yah says, I have my keli, my weapons on my garment, I'm dressed, and I shall cause the wrath of my weapons. The wind, the hailstorm. That's why the messenger of hell will cause fire to come down out of heaven. When those individuals see those rockets blaring down, it is nothing but a fire. Creating the mind to fight against Yah. It is the Torah-less mind of iniquity. And Yah says, I'm going to cause the rage of my wrath. Just like HaShatan, he says, you're not on my side, you're on his side. And I'm coming to rip your babies out of your belly. I'm coming to rip out everything you have. And that's what he is doing today. He's ripping out our conscience for Yah. He's ripping out our admiration for one another, because there are three unclean spirits that ought not to be in us. That one of covetousness, that one of murdering, that we will kill, we will hate our brothers and our sisters without a cause, and that spirit of shekhah, of lies. We lie with our conscience, we will tell a lie, we will lie against one another, we will lie on each other, we will speak lies against Yisra'iyah. Do you know something is wrong, Yisra'iyah? It is time you can lie and your conscience is so seared. It doesn't trouble you where you cannot sleep at night. That you go to your Acha, your home, and say, I was wrong, I lied against you. I spoke evil against you. What I say to her, I say it to her face. What I say to him about her, I say it to her. It takes a damn coward. I got something to say about to this Acha, I would say to him. And if I discuss with him, I discuss it in his presence. That's love. That's caring. That's concern. It is a superficial coward. Does judgment point out our sins? Does Yah love us? So he points out everything, doesn't he? He may not know where he's going wrong. You show him and you tell him. And then you let the ark be aware that they can watch for him. That's how you do it. That's right. Hallelujah. In this last verse, he says, yes, a mighty wind shall stand up against them, against the wicked, against who the Torah-less ones, the ones that delight not in the Torah. And a storm shall blow them away, the great winds and the gusts of this society, of even this, of the nature of what things are happening. Our minds are being taken from us. We can't even think about Yah because we're worried about this and we're worried about that. Our hearts are melting. They are fainting because of circumstances and situations. The world today, people, they don't even know in this nation whether their job will be there Monday or Tuesday. They are away for their hog eating, their damn pork eating, their swine belly, and they're going to grill and cook themselves in the hell. I'll never forget the article. I'm going to get that. I said to Akka Shimri, I'll get that, concerning the article or the speech that Frederick Douglass did in New York State. He said, any Negro that celebrate the 4th of July, something is twisted in his damn mind. There was no liberty for the Negro. You sit out there and frost some damn chitlins. It is a day of drunkenness, day of lust and greed and sensuality and sexuality. They come naked in this nation because it's cold, it's warm here. Everybody naked. They're drinking and they're drunkenness. I will not eat one damn piece of bread if they offered it to me. They're sacrificing it to their gods. And you don't eat that which is sacrificed to a god. You don't eat no damn Thanksgiving turkey. You don't eat that damn Christmas turkey. It's damned. It's one thing that I know, every tongue that rises up against judgment against me, I'm going to damn it. Yah says you're going to condemn it. You can deny it all you want to, but that's what he says. Hallelujah. That which is sacrificed to the gods of hell, to this nation, this country that has killed and butchered and destroyed people, and even the people of the nation of this land. And you're going to eat some damn pork shoulder? You're going to sit there in the hot sun and roast and eat that? They're celebrating their deliverance from the tyranny of Britain. Had nothing to do with the man of the diasporas. Damn the 4th of July. Damn it. You're offended by damn you. You will go to hell. And don't even give a damn about Yah's feast days. Don't give a damn about the more dim of Yah. And yet you got respect for that. Damn the 4th of July. Damn Christmas. Damn their hog day. They're not thankful. And you eat that damn mess when mama sent me a plate. Curse it. Tell mama this is what I did with it. Come here. Slam it to the damn ground. Stomp it. Tell I did that. That's my boldness. You see, that's my makeup. That's the way I am. I stand for Yahshua. I stand for the Torah of Yah. I'm not going to be a coward. I don't want your gifts. I'm not going to sit down. Well, just stop in for a minute. No, I'm not stopping in for a second. I'm not eating with you. I don't even, although it's hot, I don't even want to grill nothing on that day. Hallelujah. Because that's what this wicked nation will be doing. Hallelujah. He says, thus Torah-less iniquity shall lay waste the whole earth. Because there is no Torah guidance. Because the iniquity, the ovon, it is because it is a mind without Torah. That's why our minds have been shapen to fight against Yah. And we fight against him, Yisrael. When the messengers speak, we get mad, we get upset, we rail. You will be surprised at the many that have, this house was full, look at what we have. This house was full, friends. You all see this wall back here? I was going to tear all of this out, all of this and all of this, because we didn't have space for all the people. And how they will rise up after a meeting like this, I will preach like this, and then they will go to their secret little closets, their little secret conclaves, and speak against the messenger of Almighty Yah. You speak against the messenger of Yah, woe unto you. Were they still serving Yah like hell they are? You say what you want to. They're not even religious like hell they're serving Yah. You call it what you want to. You can try to justify them. It doesn't mean a damn thing. Yah is the one that justifies his people. And you will know it because they're not Torah-lessness. Don't tell me your sons and daughters love Yah when they defy the Shabbat of Yah. You're a damn liar. I don't care who you are. I don't give a damn. They can go to the whorehouse all day on tomorrow. Don't tell me. I don't care if they use the name Yah. It doesn't mean one thing at all. The demons know that name and they tremble. Hallelujah. You can't justify them and condemn me. Hallelujah. He said, the torahless iniquity shall lay waste the whole earth, and evil dealings shall overflow from the throne of the Almighty. There are evil dealings. We've never dealt evil, have we? We've dealt with each other with an evil consciousness. We're evil against each other. And Yah says that evil dealings shall overflow from our throne. We're going to be judged by everything we do, every word we speak. You're not getting by with nothing at all. Your little evil surmising you have locked up in your wicked, old, greasy, fat heart that I have here, you're not getting by with it at all. You have sown that when you're going to reap it, not in the time to come, the by and by. You're going to reap that now. That's why we must cleanse ourselves from all filthiness. We must cleanse ourselves from all filthiness. We must cleanse ourselves from all filthiness, first of all, of the flesh. You begin cleaning your filthy flesh and of the ruach as well, of the spirit. It is not just spirit. You clean yourself of your wicked, dirty, fleshly ways. You must impel that. You must kill it off, Yisra'iyah. It must be destroyed. It must be brought down to the gates of hell. It must be destroyed, Yisra'iyah. And you began with your damn dirty flesh. You identify that your flesh is filthy. There's dirtiness and wickedness in you. And when you began to do that, you began to acknowledge that there's a power that is greater than your flesh. That is of the ruach of Almighty Yah. So even your own evil dealings are going to flow from the throne of Yah. And they're going to flow back upon you, Yisra'iyah. These are the weapons of Yah. You have created the weapons of Yah. We have created that. It is His wrath. If HaShatan is coming with the weapon of wrath, you think Yah can fight against him any other way but with that? We must walk in the wrath of Yah. We must, when we learn the obedience of Yah, we must be with vengeance. We must turn with vengeance, be ready to exact vengeance upon that which we know was wrong. We find out it's wrong, we be ready to kill it, to take vengeance upon it by the wrath of Yah. That's what we must do, Yisra'iyah. We cannot continue to placate and pretend. We got to get this thing right. Hallelujah. These weapons are not sexual and sensual. And everything in the whole houses today are sensual. Everything. Everything is about pleasing the flesh. That's what it is. Hallelujah. The prophet Yahshua speaks about the armies of Yah's wrath. Here in Isaiah chapter 13, verse 1. You need to hear this. Hallelujah. Yahshua. In chapter 13, verse 1. He talks about the burden of Babel, which Yeshaya, the son of Amos, did see. He says, I want you to lift up a banner upon the high mountain. Exalt the voice of them. He says, and shake the hand. Shake your hand, that they may go into the gates of the noble. I want everyone to hear. I want them to know. Yah says, I have commanded, I have savar. I have commanded, I want my people to hear this. I have commanded my Chadosh one. I have also called my mighty, my Gibor, my mighty ones for my anger. He has called the mighty men, the Gibor, those that are strong and powerful with the strength of Yah. I will read that again. Yah says, I have commanded my Chadosh one. I have also called my mighty, my Gibor, my strong man, those that are warriors, ones, from my off my anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. Yah says, the noise of the multitude in the mountains is like a great people, a tumultuous noise of the Melkut of nations gathered together. It says, Yahweh of Sabaoth, of the army of the warfare of military might, he mustered the host to battle. He mustered us to the battle that is set in array. The mountains, the hair represents those that set themselves above the Torah of Yah. They're Torah-less. They don't have the wisdom of Torah. We have the wisdom of Yah that is mightier than the weapons of their warfare. We know how to deal. We know how to utilize the weaponry of Yah. Hallelujah. We know how to do that. He said they come from a far country. From the ends of Hashemayim, even Yah. He says, even Yah. Even Yah. And the weapons. And the weapons. The Kali of his. The weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land. The weapon of his indignation, that is his weapon. His af, his wrath, his indignation. He's going to destroy Yisrael. The weapons of Yah's indignation, his anger, his hamas, his violence, he's going to destroy. He's going to destroy. You cannot fight against the wrath of HaShatan and the wicked one that come unless your wrath is greater than his. You cannot fight against the wrath of America when she dropped bombs unless you have the ability to fly 10,000 miles at a shot and drop bombs. Unless you have the seaworthy vessels to sail and to carry 200 or 300 planes that can drop bombs every hour on your country, every 15 minutes, bombs are dropping. You can't do that. You cannot fight against HaShatan. That's why the battle is mine, says Yah. The battle is Yah. The victory belongs unto his Kadosh ones. And he's not going to fight with the sword. He's going to fight with his indignation. He's going to fight with this cup that runs over of the vile filth. And the sin, the wickedness, even when he fight against us, Yisrael, it is about the same pattern because his judgment is not impartial. He judges the wicked just like he judges us. There's no standard of judgment for us that is different than the wicked. And we in our self-grandizing nature, we think it's going to be different. We're damn fools. It's not going to be any different. If he's going to judge the wicked that harsh, he's going to judge us with the same cruelty and the same harshness. If he's going to judge the wicked with the indignation of his wrath, you better believe me. That's why he has allowed us to endure a period of time. 3.5 years. What the wrath of HaShatan is going to be poured out upon Yisrael. And when he comes, he is coming with great wrath. We can see the protocol of that today. He's butchering the babies in the mother's womb today. The dad is not worth a damn. Nobody even cares. Nobody cares for each other. I was listening the other day. There in Boston, I believe, that a woman died in the swimming pool, and for 2 days she was in the swimming pool and nobody even were concerned. She laid at the bottom of the swimming pool for 2 days. Nobody inquired, no one called the police. That's the nature of this nation and the mindset. We don't care about each other. And I'm not going to stop saying that. I see it everywhere I go. We don't give a damn about each other. There's no fervent ahava in the bosom of Yisrael. That's why it's going to take a fire to eradicate that out of us. It's going to take the fire of his truth to get this trash out of us. It's not going to come out any other way, Yisrael. They come from a far country. And the weapons, does it say that in your translation? And the weapons of what? His indignation, his wrath, his anger. Those are the weapons of Yah. How do you fight against that? You cannot fight against that, Yisrael. How do you raise up a standard to protect you from the wrath of Yah? How do you withstand a tornado that's 220 miles an hour? When that thing hit Joplin, Missouri, and they call Joplin, Missouri, the blue state, they call that mid-America, whereby there is morals, morality. That's what they say. That's the mindset today. places like that whereby family values, morality, and they got every kind of damn corrupt spirit there, just like it is in New York City, just like it is here in Jefferson. When Hurricane Hugo hits New Orleans down there, every kind of wicked preacher, the Jerry Falwells and all, the Pat Robertsons, they declared it was the wicked of that little people there, little poor people that didn't know a damn thing. But did you hear them say that that what happened in Joplin, Missouri, was because of this wickedness of a people that's wicked? They've hidden their wickedness. They've hidden it that no one can identify their wickedness. You hear anything like that? Yet every kind of pundit, every kind of righteous, wicked man that rose up, what happened down there, they all stood up. This is their sin. And yet whether faggot dogs, whether they're Jewish, whether they're Caucasians, whether they're black out there in San Francisco, when that place get ripped to hell, we will see what they will say. Yah said, I'm going to pour out my wrath. This is where it's supposed to be the cauldron of the beauty of essence of morality here in Joplin. Yah says, but I know the sin of Joplin. I know the sin of Jefferson, South Carolina. I know the sins of Charlotte. And in my indignation, when I pull my weapon from my sheath, whether it's the thunderbolts, the storms, the weather, I'm going to rip it to hell. He says, I'm going to be cruel. He's not going to respect baby, old man, old woman. I'm going to be cruel. Why? Because we've been cruel against Yah. He tells us the Zakah, his Shabbat, and keep it kadosh. We don't even remember it. He tells us what to do. We call him a lawyer. We challenge you. We bluff you. Bluff, bluff. See there? I did it. Nothing happened. I will. He's nothing to play with. He doesn't play. He doesn't sport. Just telling you the truth, that's all. You don't have to love me. I don't want you to love me. Hallelujah. I'm not going to finish all this today, but I'll get back on it. Show you some more weapons of Yah. Hallelujah. Nation has raised up a mind to fight against Yah. The sons and the daughters fight against mama. They fight against grandmama. They fight against great-grandmammy, and they fight against everyone. They talk to daddy any kind of way. They talk to mama. They speak to them any kind of way. And grandmama knows to shut her mouth because mammy will take the side of the wicked daughter out there in the streets hoeing like a dog, but she will take her side. The daddy will protect the wickedness of his own son. And daddy's trying to tell granddaddy and great-granddaddy trying to tell them, look, boy, you all need to change your ways. You need to get that out of your house. In the 40s, 30s, 50s, even in my days as a young man, if the daddy walked in the house and he said, now, boy, get that mess out of your house, he could be married with a wife. He would get it out. That's a fact. Daddy could walk in the house and say, boy, you ain't got no business. Where you going with that mess? You's a need to get that out of your house, boy. Go out and get it on out of here. He will go out and get it on out. Married man. He didn't talk back to his daddy. His wife didn't say, well, this is our house. We do what we want to do. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, daddy. Yes, sir, daddy. I will, man. You might as well talk to him and say hallelujah. Hallelujah. He goes on to speak in verse 6. He says, this is how Yah is going to destroy the system of Babel. The bombs are not going to destroy it. But I tell you, the winds of Yah are going to destroy it. He speaks, he says in verse 6, he says, I want you to yalal, I want you to howl, to wail, to cry, you. He said, for the day of Yah is at hand. And it shall come as a destruction from the Almighty of Almighty Yah. He said, I'm going to bring down the system of Babel. It has destroyed and handicapped. It has raped many. He says, therefore shall some hands call, even us. All hands shall be rafa, they shall be faint. And he says, every man's love shall melt. It shall masah. It shall waste away. He shall have. He did not say some. You see the how impartial his judgment is and the purity of Yah's judgment. He says, and they shall be afraid. Pains and sorrow shall take hold of them. He said, they shall be in pain as a woman that travails. They shall be amazed one at another. And their face shall be as lahab, shall be as flame, as the sharp polished blade of a sword. He says, the day of Yah comes. Is it kind? It is cruel. Azakhari. Did I not just read here in the book of wisdom? It says here in the book of wisdom what I read, wisdom 5:22. And hailstones full of wrath shall be cast out of a stone bow. Not a wooden bow, but Yah's bow is one of stone. And the waters of the sea shall rage against them, and the flood shall cruelly drown them. Did I not read that? Does not Yahshua speak with the same volume of prophetic utterance? He says, the day is a cruel day. The baby shall weep, but it's a cruel day, and they shall die. It's a cruel day in this nation. They butcher. Even among the diasporas, the people of that small denomination in this nation, they butcher 2,600 babies a week. They're carnal. They love sexual practice. And they're butchering 2,600 babies a week. She gets pregnant, butcher the baby. Kill the baby. But yet no one sees that as cruel. They see that as a woman's right. And yet when it comes to Yah, they say it's cruel. But you're going to pay, my friend. And there is no doubt about that when you're going to pay. It is the day. It is the day of Yah. It is a mighty day, the day that he has made, the day of Yah. It comes, it's a cruel day. And this day is so cruel, not only that, both with wrath, the evra, the outpouring of the indignation of Yah. And he says it is the harum, the fierce anger. To lay the land desolate, shema, wasted, annihilated, destroyed. These are the weapons of Yah, his anger, his wrath. That's why he is angry with the wicked, the rasha, the condemned every day. When we don't acknowledge our wickedness is right. When you're wrong against your ach, your achot, to tell them you're wrong. It's right. Let there be no kind of division among Yisra'iyah. When you hide it, it's because you're cruel. You will butcher, you will kill. Because these are the three unclean spirits that goes out of those that are not of Yah. The spirit of covetousness, you can't never have enough. The spirit of murdering, and also, my friend, the spirit of shekha, you a lie. And you don't give a damn. You will speak lies and you don't even have a conscience. What a dirty Jezebel. For in hell you shall lift your eyes. And that's the truth. With the fierce anger of Yah to lay the land desolate. And he shall not. He's going to exterminate the sinner thereof out of it. Who is the sinner? When we defy the Torah and we do it blatantly, when we are blatant in our action, we're sinners. For all have sinned, and we all have sinned. But what a man is a sinner, he practices things. He lay it to heart to do it. He knows it's against the Torah because his heart is Torah-less. There's no power Torah. When a man goes out to commit an act that is so vile, he plans it out. He carries out the thoughts of his mind, and then he enacts upon it. A very few things that just happen chance. Man doesn't meet a woman and say, well, what's up, girl? Let's go do our thing. No, that it doesn't happen that way. He doesn't go to the court and buy a prostitute because he wants to do that. That's in his heart. And that's what we have done with Yah. We have gone and we have contemplated in our bosom. I don't like that, what he said. I don't want that, but I want this. And we began to dismantle the ways of Yah. And then our bosom become Torahlessness. There's no power of Torah in us at all. The weapons, they're mighty. And they're going to pull down the strongholds of hell. There are strongholds in us that hold us. It's going to take the wrath of Yah. It's almost like a parent when that little dirty, effeminate of a boy and that little Jezebel of a daughter, when mama just said, or dad is, that's it, when he just went ballistic. When my Ema would go ballistic, it would last for a while. When she would say, take it off, boy, when she meant that, I was too fearful not to take the shirt off. And when she would drop that drop cord, and I lied to you, not, I'm not trying to say something to make me look fine, hell. When she would say, take it off, her anger, her anxiety. In those days, if they had examined me, they would have took, I would not have let them done that to me. I would not have let them done that to my mother. I would not have. I would not have even told that she did that to me. But I tell you what, it will make me find me a little secret, quiet place. And I will find myself thinking on my actions and my deeds. I know that. And I know I wasn't so quick to do it again. I will watch myself. She would have me covered from head down all the way down. She would put it on me. Those little brown drop cords, she would fold that thing and she would make it work. See, because the switch didn't do anything, I had become numb to that. So she said, this here, you're not numb to this. And she get the whacking on that, and yet if you didn't cry out the first one or the second one, you in trouble. And she began to pour it out. You understand? Now, if a mother that will not leave a suckling child, that would do that to me, what do you think, yeah? Who has birthed us by the precious atonement of the dam of Yahshua. And then we take that for naught and we think that we're going to get by. We think that that's all to him. We're wrong, Yisrael. We're not going to get by at all. I want to read one more thing and I'm going to close today. Hallelujah. I'm going to close here and then I want to finish this up. Yah's will on Shabbat. I want to continue here in the 15th chapter, the 54th chapter of the book of Yeshaya. And this is a message to Yisrael for our assurance in this tremendous time of the battle. Yeshaya 54, verse 15. He said, behold, they shall surely gather together. Yah said, but not by me. They're gathering themselves together, but not by my command, not by my instruction. Whosoever shall gather together against you shall fall. They shall not fall. Those that gather against Yisrael, they're going to fall. And this is a wicked nation that always gathers against the messengers of Yah. Yah says this. He said, behold, they shall surely gather themselves together. They shall find themselves in their conclaves. And I've watched this house as they would gather after the service and gather themselves against the messenger of Yah. And Yah says, but not by me. I have not brought them together. He said, whosoever shall gather themselves together against you, they shall surely not fall. It shall be a violent death. It shall be a violent fall. They're going to die for your sake. Yah says, behold, I have barah, I have created the smith. And that smith is harash. Those that are skillful in the military weaponry. And I'm a skilled warrior. I know how to use the sword. I know how to use it. Hallelujah. He said that blows the coals in the fire and that brings forth an instrument, a keli, a weapon from his work. I have created the wasters. Yah says, I have created the wasters to destroy. He has created those that cause your homes, your children to be wasted. Yah says, I've created them to destroy. That's what Yah says. He says to me, Yisrayah, he says, no cheli, no weapon that is formed or created against you, it shall shalach. It will not prosper. It will not make progression. They will not succeed. He said, I want you to know this for your own benefit. Every tongue that shall rise against you in their wicked judgment, he said, you shall damn it. Damn them. You shall condemn. You shall condemn. No, this is not in the Bible. He said, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of Yah. And their tzaddik is of me, says Yah. For the judgment is of Yah. So you all may think I'm strange when I say, damn them. Every tongue that rises up in judgment against Yisrayah, you'll say, you damn it. You servant of Yah, this is your heritage. This is the heritage of Yisrayah. His wrath is going to be poured out in a way that is uncontrollable. The weapons of Yah, the slaughtering weapons of Yah. He caused the winds to blow and they slaughter and kill. He caused the winds to blow and it uproots thousands. He's causing the sorest river to flow in North Dakota and the city will never be the same. It will never. His winds are blowing. The wrath of Yah is kindled against the sinners and we that are practitioners of wickedness, where we will not allow the Torah to dictate to us and to create this affinity and love for Yah, because everything that he speaks in the book is of judgment. It is of warning, then judgment. He blesses us, but he warns us about the riches. Don't take it and do that. Don't take it and do that. And he warns us of the consequences. It is about the instructions of his warning and judgment and the results of his judgment if we do not obey. This is our heritage. This is the heritage of Yisrayah. And when the tongues rise up in judgment of condemnation against you, then what? Do you pray for them? Then you shall condemn them. May the riches of Yah rest upon you that have joined us for the live broadcast. You hear Yisrayah. We're here because we love you. We do care for you, Yisrayah. We want you to understand truth. Yabarak. We encourage you that have joined us. May the riches of Yah rest upon you all in Yahshua's name. May he strengthen you. May the battles that you're all encountering, may Yah grant unto you the liberty or the liberation from those trials by Imun, our faith in Yahshua. Yabarak. Let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. As we turn toward the city of Yerushalayim, toward the east, in all things we do barak you this day, Yah. We lift you up for your kindness, your mercy this day. We know that you love Yisrayah. We're glad that you judge us and show us, Yah. We know that your actions are going to be cruel, and sometimes it takes the cruel speech to awaken your people. Not sometimes, it takes that, Yah. Help us to internalize this in the Ruach, that we rejoice greatly that you have granted unto us a liberty this day to love you. We will hover you for all things. Protect your people, those that are going through trials and great afflictions. Look upon them in Yahshua's name and give them shalom and strength to the burden of the heavy yoke that they will not succumb to it. Bless all your messengers, men, servants, wherever they are throughout the nations of the earth. We ask it all in Yahshua's mighty name. Strengthen me and all of your people, all of our ach and our holtz. Rock them all in Yahshua's name. Hallelujah. 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 Yabra.